हेलो कोडिंग गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल कोड विद अ की। हाउ आर यू डूइंग गाइज? एज यू गाइज नो, वी आर लॉन्चिंग द होल रिएक्ट हुक सीरीज इन विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट टू मेजर हुक, विच इज अ बेसिक हुक, यूज स्टेट एंड यूज इफेक्ट। सो वी आर नाउ गोइंग टू लर्न यूज कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन दिस वीडियो। वी विल लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट थ्रू द स्लाइड्स एंड देन इम्प्लीमेंट इट थ्रू लाइव कोडिंग एग्जाम्पल। वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू use the context in functional component as well as in class component. So let's get started. Or if you are new here, please subscribe this channel to learn more stuffs related to React and other programming language. So let's get started. So as you guys know, use context is another hook, which is a basic hook like use state and use effect. And use context is very, very important if you guys want to build a large application where you guys going to use this hook, which is a very, very powerful hook here. So we will first discuss the key points what we will going to learn in this particular video. So first of all, we will introduce how we will use context in our application and when to use the context, why to use context. Then we will learn it through a live coding example, and we will also discuss how we can use this context in class component, which where we will learn the context provider, right? So what is the meaning and the usage of the context? So basically, context provides a way to pass data through the component tree without having to pass properties down manually at every level. Means if you have a large component tree and all the component needs that particular thing, and you don't want to pass that particular thing explicitly for all the components, right? So it will be very cumbersome for us to simply pass or manually pass the properties down to a large component tree. So here the context comes here, and it just provide us a way where we can simply declare or simply pass the data through the component tree without passing it at every level. Basically, we will wrap it the whole component tree inside a parent component, and we'll just pass the context, the data using the context to that, and it will be simply accessible by all the components of the tree that is the children of that particular component. So that's where the context just provide a way just to pass the data without passing it through all the components that it just required. You can just simply declare it once and use it anywhere. Let's discuss some important points. So basically, as we all know, context provide the way to share values between components without explicitly pass a property through every level that we have already discussed here. The next one is a component calling use context will always re-render when the context value changes. Means when the context value will be changed, it will re-render every time the data is being changed, right? So let's match it with through an example. Suppose you have an authentication system and you have already authenticated a user, right? So when there will be any change in the user state, so basically you want to re-render that particular component one more time for that particular user. So here the use context is very, very necessary, right? So you have to, here the main motive is just like that. When you use the use context, it will re-render when there will be any change in the data that you have passed as a value properties in the provider, right? Next question arises, why do we use context? So basically Why is it necessary to use context, right? So how we will use it, right? So typically in React application, data is passed top down, means parent to children via properties, right? So basically what we have in the React application, the data is passed just like a parent, their sub children, sibling, then their children is just like a hierarchical system where the data is passed from top to down, means parents to child, through the properties that we have, that we just pass it explicitly. But such usage can be cumbersome for certain type of properties, just like you have a UI theme and you just want this UI theme for the every web, every pages or React pages you have, and you don't want to pass the UI theme explicitly to all the components that you use. So here comes the context. So basically you just declare the context one time and just wrap it, the whole component, inside that inside the provider, and it's just simply accessible to all the component that you have passed inside this. So it just provide us a way to just simply saves our lot of manual work it improves the reusability of the code, right? So we have a language preference here on the a lot of websites where you can see we have a language preference. So the user will set it once at a time, whether it will be Hindi or English, okay, any other languages, and when the user has already preferred the language, the next time when the user access that website, it just comes what they have already chosen there. So basically the local preferences means once you have authenticated the user, so you don't want to authenticate the user every time there will be a page that will be changed. So basically you just want it to authenticate a single time, and you can simply pass the access, just provide the access to the user, the all the web pages that we have. So there comes the use context. So basically use context provides us the all the things here, right? So now question arises, when do we use context? So context is designed to share data, and that can be considered global for a tree. Think it like that. You just want the things to be shared, the data that is a global for a tree, means all the React component needs that properties, so that it can be accessible by the respective components. So basically it just for a global, it just considered the data is global, and all the components just want to access over it. So then you can simply make context of that data, and you can simply pass it through the React component basically here. So here just like an example where we have a user authentication UI theme and the preferred language, right? Now let's discuss the syntax here. So syntax is very simple for the use context here. So here we have a value, and here we can use this value anywhere in our application, right? So where we have a value which is a use context, and here inside of this use context we just pass the argument that is my context that we have created using the create context, right? So basically it just accepts the object that you guys can see in the parenthesis, how do we create a context object? Then we have a react.createContext function. It just create the context object, and we just pass it inside the use context argument, and for using the current value of this use context, we will have the name of the context, that is my context.provider, and here we will simply pass the value properties, and it just have the current value that is determined by the value properties of the nearest my context.provider. So the syntax is very 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 simple for the use context here, right? So now it's time to learn it through an example. Hope you would like these slides. You guys got everything that you want to learn in the use context, and I hope you just learn about the use context very well in this part. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, you can simply drop your queries or suggestion in the comment box. I will reply your comments. If you just want to ask a question personally to me, you can simply DM me on the Instagram. I will drop in the link in the description. So let's learn it through an example. Okay, so we will meet in the Visual Studio Code. So let's get started in the Visual Studio Code, right? We already have a very basic example of use context hook, where we have using a functional component here. As you guys can see here, we have a toggle theme where we will see the how we can change the theme from dark mode to light mode. If you can see here, when I click on this switch, we have a dark mode and the light mode, which is that is what we will use in our UI theme if we have a large application. So where you can see here, we have already declared create our context object, that is using a create context. We have here we have exported it because we can use it anywhere in our application, so that's why we have exported it. So we have a theme context, and where we have just created an object using a React dot create context here. And then we have an app here, and here we are using a use state hook. Here we have a night theme. Initially it is true, so that's why here you can see here we have this dark theme here. And then we have a function there. We will simply toggle the theme between the dark mode and the night mode here. So we have a toggle theme function here, and then here you can see here we have a theme context. This is the important thing that we are talking about here. So this is the theme context that we have already created it using a create context here, right? And we just wrap this theme context, and where we use a provider, and it just takes a single value, which is as properties, and we have passed the value the night theme here. Basically the night theme is a state which acts like a state which contains a boolean of true value. So we have a night theme here that is automatically have a true state right now. We have this, and then we have a button where we will able to toggle between the theme. It just basically will it just simply toggle the theme between the day and the night here. And here you can see we have an icon, so that's why we have using an SVG here for this icon. So when I click on this switch, you can see here we have an updated version of it. But this is not the complete task that you have seen here. So basically this is the important thing, the theme context dot provider. So basically the theme context provider is what just wraps the whole component tree inside this. So just suppose if we have a 10 or 15 components, right? And in all that component we just want these things, this dark and the light theme for all that 15 components. So it will be very very cumbersome for us to write manually this light theme or dark theme for all React pages. So here comes the theme context provider. So basically it just wrap around all those components which required this value, this night theme value, right? Which requires this night theme value, and it just acts like a global state or global data, right? It just acts like a global data where we use these things, right? So it just acts like a global data that can be shared among all the components, all the React components that is going to use it, right? So we have a theme context dot provider, and we just wrap, we have a button, and here we just wrap a component that is going to use here, which is a theme component here. So here you can simply pass any number of components that you just want these things to be used here. So here we will create a class component. So basically it is just a functional component. I will show you first the functional component of the theme component, and then we will explain it through the class component, how you can implement it through the class component, right? So it's just a simple there is just a difference between the functional component and the class component implementation of a huge context hook there, right? So we will explain the distinction, that is the difference between both of these, and how we will tackle all these things here. So basically we have a theme which is a functional component here. So now I'm just going to save this first of all, and here you can see here we have a theme context provider and all that thing that we have discussed here right now here. So basically when I click on this, it just changes here. So here that you can see here the value, that is the night theme, it just passed automatically to this component, that is this theme. As you guys can see here, this theme, it just passed as a property to this theme component. And inside of this theme components, now you can see here we have this theme component here. So we have a theme component here which is a functional component, and here we just use the hook, that is use context. So here comes the magic happens, and here we just pass the theme context that we have already created using the react.create context, which is a function. And here we just pass the theme context inside the use context parenthesis, right? And the use context that I already explained in the slides here. If you can see here, you can see here the current value determined by the value property, the nearest my context dot provider means the updated value, the last updated value will be the current value that we have in the value properties of the nearest context provider. So here you can see here, so here basically we have this huge context, and here we just have a theme context. So basically theme context have dark theme, so it will be the current value for the huge context here is the dark theme here. And then we have a div, and here we just add a custom styles here. So when the theme is true, means the dark theme, then we will have a background color of black, and the color of the text the background color of the dark for the dark theme, and for the light theme we have this background color, and we have same thing for this also. And then we have this margin and the padding here, and the last, that is we have added the style here in the theme style, that is inside of this div. And here we have a h1 which has a huge context hook there. So I will tell you one more thing here, that let me open the Visual Studio Code, that the huge context hook simplifies our work, because in the functional component we use the use context hook, but it is complete different scenario when you will go through the class component, because you have to provide here, because we have a theme context provider here, and whenever there will be a class component, then you guys simply use the huge context. No, you can't use the huge context there, because there is a class component where you can use the theme context dot provider. Okay, so provider and the consumer. So basically we will explain it through an example by building a class component here. So let's build a class component. I hope this huge context will be cleared. Huge context will be cleared through this example a little bit here, and you can see here we have just simply toggle the theme between the dark theme and the light theme here. So this is where this magic happened, the theme magic that is happen here. So now let's create a class component. So I just create the class component inside here. So class theme, let me put the name here, class theme.js, and here we will use a snippet for the class component, that is React CRCPE. So here we have this React export pure Here we have a very basic React component, a class component here. So basically we will use this. So first of all, what you have to do, you have to first you have to first add this class theme component inside the app.js, where we just provide the theme context here. So after that theme, here we will add a class theme. So class theme component also we will add it there, and it will now access this value properties. You guys can see it will now access this night theme properties there. So here we have a class theme here, and it just access this value properties here, and now we can use this value inside our class theme here. So first of all, let's save this app.js, right? And here inside of this class theme.js, here you can see here we have a very basic class component snippets here, and here we will first add first of all import the theme context. So let's import the theme context. So theme context from React, from local app.js file, and where we have this theme component. And there here first what we will do, we will first add the styles that we will have. So we have this theme styles. So theme styles, it will take an object that is a theme object, and here we will use this object that it just have this have the value which is a dark theme there, right? It just have a value there which is a boolean of true or the false value. And here we will have this things. So you can see here we have this background cloud and everything here. So let's copy this and paste it down here inside of this, right? Let's add this. Okay, right. So we have these things, theme styles here. Okay, let's add the let me remove this, add the return statement first of all here, return, and just grab everything and put it inside this. So we have this. Let me add the curly braces, fine. Let me remove this. Oops, yeah, fine, right? So we have a theme style here, and now we will have a function. So let me add this. So inside of the return statement of the render function, we have a theme context. So first of all, let me add this theme context dot consumer, not provider. We have to nest it under a consumer there. So this is the weird nesting that you have to do with the class component if you are using the context in the class component, right? So you have to do this, but it is very 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 easy for when we use the use context hook with the class component, with functional component, right? So with the functional component, it is very very simple for us to use this, but in the class component we have to do a weird nesting here. Or inside this nesting we will have a theme here. So let me add this. We have this theme, not captain, we have this theme like this, and or you can simply remove the parentheses, you just put it like this. So we have this theme, and then we have an arrow function here for this theme, and here we will add a div here. So here we will have a div which have the, let me give just give the style here, and here for this style we have this theme style. So first of all we have to bind this. So this dot theme styles, and here inside of this div we have a class component. So basically we will add an h1 tag. So we put this at h1 tag like this, and here we'll put hello from class. So this is how you can use this use context.consumer for the class component there, and we have done with this. And let just save this or refresh this page. Okay, just refresh the page. Okay, we have an error here, the style property, right? The style property is margin, right? Okay, I just got the error. Okay, fine. Okay, let me so here you just have to pass the theme here. Okay, now save this. Okay, so we have both. Okay, I think let me put the margin 3. Now save this. Okay, so fine. We have both of things here. Use context, which is from the functional component, and now it is from the class component. Now when I click on this switch, now you can see here it is now synchronously. We have both of things is updated in front of us. So we are done with this. So here we have this class component where we have a weird nesting here. And if you use the functional component, then you will use only simple this line and only single this line. So this is where the real magic happened with the functional component. So many of you and I also prefer of using the functional component because it is very easy and very simple to learn or grasp the concept, right? So if you see the class component, we have to write a very weird, just to add these things, we just have to write the very weird nesting, and we have all these things here. So basically, there is a lot of chance of having error in the function in the class component if you use the class component. But in the functional component, it is a very simple when there is the introduction of hook that comes in the functional component with the functional component. So now you can see here we are done with this. Now you can see here we have a switch of the we are simply toggling the theme between. So here it is now for the class component and the functional component. We are done with this. So I hope you would like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe this channel and like this video. Just press the thumbs up. Give the thumbs up button. And now in the next from the next part in this series, we will learn more advanced hooks, that is use ref, use reducer, use imperative value, use debug value, use callback value, use memo, and all that thing. So we have already covered the three basic hooks here. Now we will shift our focus to the advanced hook that is very important. The additional hook that is very important if you just want to build a large React application, React web application. So you will gonna to implement all that hooks in your application. All the hooks have their own possibilities or all has on its importance. So it is very important for us to learn the React hook, as if you are a React beginner in the React or just want to learn the React here. So basically the hook is now the heart of React. So I hope you would like this tutorial. We will meet in the next part. Till then, if you are new here, just subscribe this channel. Let's